Yes, come through, random eyeshadow colors, baby. This is a whole mood, a whole vibe, a whole look. If you wanna see how I achieve this pop of rings and this bold lip, then go ahead and keep on watching this video, because you about to get your edges snatched. What's up, you guys? It's your girl RaeBae Glam, and if you are here to continue to watch me recreate that bum look you just saw, then you came to the right place, sis. So I've already done my eyebrows. They look crazy because I don't have any makeup. So I'm going to get into a new method of my makeup. I used to do my makeup like this a few years ago, and I started trying different ways and starting different ways to do my makeup. So I'm gonna go back to the basics on this. I'm actually going to start my eyeshadow first. And the reason I want to start my eyeshadow first is because I feel like I bake way too long. So anyway, we're just gonna switch it up for this time. And if I like it, I may keep it that way. So first I'm gonna prime my eyelids. And you guys know, or you don't know, I really don't use eyeshadow primer. I just use good old fashioned concealer. And my concealer I'm going to use is the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin in the shade 5.0. I'm not doing too much bright colors. The brighter the color, I would brighten up my concealer, but this is just flow so the shadows can have something to stick to. So let me go ahead and place. Bam. Now, this next step I'm going to do, it's what I used to do too, but I stopped doing it, is the tape method. So I like the tape method. It gives you those sharp crease lines, and it helps you, you know, view messy like I am. Helps you keep those shadows in place. So we're gonna place some tape. Now, I got three different shadow palettes that I'm gonna use to create this look. I got my and Breezy palette, y'all. I got my Masquerade Mini Palette from Juvia's Place. Y'all can make some bum shadows, and they're black on. And I have my Revolution Pro Day and Night Palette. So, it's not like it's a lot, but it's specific colors in each palette that I want to use to create this look. So, let's go ahead and get to it. I love the browns in my Ambreeze palette. So, that's what I want to use as my base shadows to build up, to get ready for the color I'm going to add today. So, let me get a fluffy brush. And let's go ahead and add this color. So the first color I'm going to go with, let's go with New Yorker. That's what it says up in here. The next one we're going to go with is OG. Now I'm supposed to go to 1988, which is the year I was born. The great 88. We're gonna go in, we're gonna put that color right on top of the other colors we were doing. And we're gonna go with Hugo. You know, and we're not gonna. Now, we're gonna do a cut crease. So let me take my concealer brush. And the trick for me to do a cut crease is the blink method. So I'm gonna show you what that means in just a second. So you wanna take a little concealer on your brush like this. I'm gonna take my mirror, but you'll see. You'll see my blink, sis. What you wanna do is just place some concealer like here and blink, and wherever, because what you're trying to do is lay the concealer where your natural eye lid will close, so it won't be too out of place. So for me, that's about right here. Everybody's eye shape is different. Then you're gonna follow that line. And this is definitely not something you wanna rush. Because the line is where you're going to, where the original shadow stops, and you're gonna place your new shadow. And it helps to tilt your head back too. Look what I'm doing right here. And I normally do like a 3/4 cut crease, but this time we're gonna go all the way, sis. We're gonna do the whole lid. I kind of wing her out at the end, not like a real wing, but it's shaping your eye. So just think of how your eye shape is going to look when you put the shadow on. That's what you're going for. If you like the shape, you can leave it like that, but I'm gonna add a little bit more because I wanna bring some pieces, some shadow up. I'm gonna add a dab of concealer, not a lot, just a dab. Okay, that's perfect to me. But you don't want to add your shadow on immediately because it's going to be clumpy. You won't let this dry down. So we're going to do the other eye the exact same way. Now, my eyes are ready for... My lid is ready for what I'm gonna do next. So I wanna take my Masquerade by Juvia's Palace. I just give it its own name. I give it your own name. And I'm going to go, just a second. I'm gonna use this green shade here. Y'all, I've had this palette so long, but I've never actually used all the shades. So I know I wanted to top this shade off with this pretty color in this Day and Night palette by Revolution Pro. I don't know what it's called, sleep, maybe I'm reading backwards, But I'm going to spray my brush, this little brush, with some Missing Fix right here. I'm gonna go into this, so this is my first time using this palette too, so. Oh, I gotta take the plastic off. I can get it. Then I'm gonna go back in with a small flat tapered brush. and I said that I was going to go over with this teal color here. So I'm going to go with that color. We're going to do the same thing to the other side. So let me grab my brush. Now we're going to do our wing. So for our wing, this is the Stella Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner in the shade Intense Black. Intense Black, you guys. So, excuse my chair. We're going to go right on over here. I'm going to have to use this mirror, y'all, because... Looks good. Now we're going to enforce some colors, those colors at the bottom of the lash line. Actually, let me add this color. I got this from Walmart. Hard Candy Strokes of Gorgeous Soft Glide Long Wear Eyeliner. And it is in the color Bright Intensity Deep Sea. Let's see, sis. Let's see. She's nice. She's tying together. Now I want to take a small fluffy brush. And which colors do I want? Definitely going to take a little bit of the darker shades that I use with the browns. I'm going to take 1988. We're going to brush that on the lower bottom lash line. Hold up. Now I'm back to 1988. The great 1988. Long brush. Y'all, my dog is scratching at my door once again. She's scratching at my door. Actually, I'm gonna take the day and night and that like chameleon type color. I wanna add that at the bottom too. Let me do my mascara. Like, I'm really doing eyes. Well, you know what? Let's get the mascara. Let's set my problem areas with some setting powder. Y'all, this look is pretty. Use my NARS Soft Matte Foundation. And I'm in the shade Macau Deep Medium 4. Okay. Get this hair back. Out my way. Out my eye. Jeez, always that one eye, y'all. It's always that one eye. So we just want to place. Now we're going to take our concealer. Now make sure you ain't taking off the stuff that you did already on your eyes. So you just want to put it like right below. While that's sitting, we're going to do our eyelash primer and our mascara. Because the eyes are already dead, babe. Let's go ahead and blend out our concealer. Now I'm gonna go into my bronzer. Let's not forget to set our concealer with our Fenty Beauty setting powder in Shea Cashew. We're almost done, sis. Kinda. We gotta add blush. Like, come on. You know what? This is my MAC blush. It is called Extra Dimension Blush. It's She's pink and kinda, she's a little extra. I'm going to go with my Too Faced Melted Matte in the shade Drop Dead. So let's go ahead and apply her. This is one of my favorite formulas in. And here you guys is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I did. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. See you in my next video.